knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Earlier in this series, we talked about heterocycles, and one important aromatic heterocycle is the indole, a bicyclic structure involving benzene fused with pyrrole. Indoles are widespread in nature, acting as common subunits of bioactive molecules. Here are some examples of biologically relevant compounds featuring indoles, such as tryptophan, an amino acid, strychnine, an alkaloid found in certain plants, and serotonin, a neurotransmitter. Due to their prevalence in nature, their synthesis has been the object of much attention. A very important route to indoles is the Fischer synthesis, which was discovered in 1882 by the famous German chemist Emil Fischer, who was a Nobel Prize winner in 1902. Here we see the reaction illustrated for the simple case of phenylhydrazine and acetone. However, it works generally for all aryl hydrazines and ketones. So let's talk about each of these steps in a bit of detail. It is well known that one can condense an aryl hydrazine with a ketone, involving the elimination of water. This is usually done with acid catalysts, where the removal of water will drive the equilibrium forward. This yields aryl hydrazones like this one, which are often crystalline compounds. These hydrazones can be treated with strong Bronsted-Lowry acids like hydrochloric, phosphoric or sulfuric acid, and even Lewis acids like aluminum trichloride, to yield indoles. We can probably identify the atoms from each of the starting materials in the product, but we will also notice that we start with two nitrogen atoms and we end up with only one, so the mechanism must account for the loss of one nitrogen atom. As it turns out, the mechanism for this second step is quite complex, but let's take a look at it. Here is the result of the first step, involving phenylhydrazine and some ketone of at least four carbons. Now we begin with the acid catalysis and shuffling of protons. First, this nitrogen is protonated, it being more basic, since its lone pair is not tied up in resonance with the neighboring ring, like the other nitrogen. Then a proton is lost at this beta position, putting a pi bond here and neutralizing the nitrogen to yield this ene hydrazine. Protonation occurs again at the same nitrogen as the first time. This is where something interesting happens. We talked about sigmatropic shifts a little earlier in the series, so if that term is unfamiliar, you may want to refresh your memory with that tutorial. Otherwise, this intermediate will undergo a 3-3 sigmatropic shift, which generates the crucial carbon-carbon bond at the ortho position of the benzene ring. This species isomerizes immediately to the more stable aniline form, thereby restoring the aromaticity of the ring. Then the nitrogen from the aniline moiety attacks the iminium ion in intramolecular fashion to secure the 5-membered ring. At this point, one of these protons is lost, and then acid catalyzes the elimination of ammonia. And there we have the indole with the mechanism understood. Now, the situation is more complex when the ring is substituted. We can look at the 3-3 shift as a reaction in which the orthocarbon of the electron-rich aniline attacks the electron-poor alkene. Thus, the more electron-rich the aniline, the faster the reaction. Therefore, if electron-donating substituents are present on the ring, the reaction is accelerated. If electron-withdrawing substituents are present, the reaction is hindered, and in extreme cases, it just does not occur. But when introducing substitution, there is another complicating issue, that of the resulting site selectivity. It is the case that if the aryl hydrazine is para-substituted, given the symmetry of the molecule, the substituent can only end up at the C5 position of the indole. When numbering indoles, the nitrogen is always position 1, then we number around the 5-membered ring, and then continuing to the other, skipping the two carbons involved in both rings. If the hydrazine is ortho-substituted, the substituent will always end up at the C7 position, because one of the carbons that could close the second ring is occupied. However, if the substituent is meta, two possible products exist, because there are two carbons that are free to be involved in the cyclization, resulting in the C4 and C6 substituted products. Here we look at the specific substituent to know which will predominate. If R is electron releasing, para attack is usually favored, although not completely, and the major product is the one where R is at C6. If R is electron withdrawing, selectivity is very poor, and one can expect both C4 and C6 substitution, unless R is very bulky, in which case the C6 substitution tends to prevail. Of course, with the presence of more than one substituent, the situation becomes highly complex. So far, we have used acetone, a symmetrical ketone, where the two sides are equivalent, but there are many other types of ketones that could be involved, some of which could yield multiple products. If only one side of the ketone can enolize, then this is the one taking part in the sigmatropic shift, and only one product can form, such as when using this ketone involving a phenyl group. The situation becomes more complex for non-symmetrical ketones in which both sides can enolize. In this case, two products will arise. When using strong acids like methane sulfonic acid, enolization tends to occur at the less substituted side of the ketone. In this case, let us assume we are dealing with an alkyl methyl ketone. Enolization at the methyl group will yield the major product, and enolization at the other side will give the minor product. The exact ratios depend on the identity of R, of course, and on the reaction conditions, with the preference eroding if weaker acids are used as catalysts. However, the trend we have just discussed is quite consistent. So that's some information on this name reaction. In the case of complications with this synthesis, there are other approaches to forming indoles. Nevertheless, the Fischer synthesis is a classic inorganic synthesis, and is usually the one that comes to mind first when one is planning to make an indole.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.